film, of course, we should not take it an exact historical narrative. I think the filmmakers also claim that it is an act modified from the acts of history. And at that time, child marriages were very common. The filmmakers have taken a lot of liberties with the real happenings and the real incidents of history to suit to the needs of the market and commercial things. And that's why another implicit reason may be that child marriage and something which should be abhorred totally, which should be opposed, not to show that probably the story writer and the director must have avoided that particular incident. Tatya Tope was an important historical character, not only who mentored Jhansi Ki Rani, but he had also an important role in 1857, a battle against the British. Now, of course, as I said earlier, this film is trying to glorify selectively and wants to attribute everything to Jhansi Ki Rani as if she was self-made and all the virtues were there in her inherently. So this is, I must say that the liberties which directors and this thing has taken, it is not exact depiction of the historical facts. Most of the biographies and the historical accounts which are there do not focus much on her upbringing and the education, especially that of English variety. Obviously, the way it is projected in the film, as if she was perfectly tutored in the English to combat and confront the British officers the way she did. But again, this seems to be sort of a underplaying her earlier part of life, where she might have been tutored into different types of education. So one book, of course, they keep referring again and again. They also show a very big collection of books, which is doubtful whether such a big library she had in her palace where she was staying. So this is again, seems to be more a work of fiction than of a historical narrative. British were trying to take over different princely states. They adopted various forms, either fighting against the kings, winning them over. And in this particular case, they had brought in what is called doctrine of lapse. Now, as per the doctrine of lapse, wherever the biological heirs are not there, British assumed on themselves the role of taking over the particular state. Now, here that's where the central part of the film is, that there is an attempt to manufacture and construct a nationalism. Indirectly, Rani Jhansi had to fight against British because they were not giving her, they were not giving inheritance to the adopted son. But the film actually is an attempt to create a sort of a nationalism and thereby a Riyasat of Jhansi, which was a one state at that time, that is presented as a symbol, as an equivalent to the whole country and a nation, which was not really the case. The film has lot of imagination, and because of that imagination, they are underplayed those parts which don't fit into their narrative which they want to build up, and that is about a particular type of nationalism, a sort of a muscular nationalism, I can call, a stronger nationalism. That seems to be the underlying theme of the whole script which runs it. And since they want to present this sort of a muscular nationalism, they are using underplaying this incident of adopted son not being recognized by the British, and as if she naturally wanted to fight the British because they were foreigners and all that. But that again was not the case. As far as Jhansi's story is concerned, they definitely wanted to take it over, and here they saw pretext of adopted son to impose their rule, which Jhansi Ki Rani, this Manikarnika, opposed in this particular case. She died while fighting the British, and she died in the battlefield. So logically, if one sees, it is unlikely that some hermit was there who was along with her and who must have undertaken to burn her wounded body rather than British taking over her. This seems to be a figment of imagination. Whatever historical points we know, in that she died in the battlefield. And after dying in the battlefield, how was the body handled? Who took it over? That's a matter of great conjecture, which one cannot say very, very definitely. Overall, the presentation is such as if to glorify the Queen as an anti-British fighter, as a queen sacrificing for motherland, as a queen working for the whole Indian nation, Bharat. Bharat word is used very often, which doesn't seem to be the truth at that time. Most of the rulers of the princely states who fought against British, they primarily fought because British were bringing in policies which were trying to undermine their power, which were trying to take them over. That was the reason which brought them along with the rebelling peasants. So again, as the narrative of self-sacrifice projects a glorious thing, so that is currently probably the fashion or the trend which was used in Padmavat and which has partly in a modified way also been picked up in this film. So I must say, all in all, put it together, the director, the story script writer have taken a real liberty to create a Jhansi Ki Rani of their own imagination.